Students, our next experiment is determination of viscosity of given liquid by using Ostwald viscometer. It is our Ostwald viscometer. Okay, it is our Ostwald viscometer. It consists of two bulbs, bulb A and bulb B. We can observe here. It consists of two bulbs A and B. Bulb B consists of capillary tube. Observe here. We can find the difference between bulb A and bulb B. Bulb A consists of what? Bulb A consists of normal tube. We can observe here. It is normal tube. It is capillary tube. So bulb B consists of capillary tube. Bulb A consists of normal tube. Okay. First, our aim to calculate the surface tension of the given liquid. Our aim to calculate the viscosity of the given liquid by using Ostwald viscometer. Here, it is our Ostwald viscometer. By using this, we can calculate the viscosity of the given liquid. To calculate the viscosity of the given liquid, first we should calculate the viscosity of the water. For that purpose, we should take that water through bulb A, which consists of normal tube. Okay, take some amount of water through bulb A up to bulb B. Whenever the bulb B half filled, we should stop the addition of water from A side, because bulb B consists of capillary tube. We can observe here, it is the capillary tube. Observe here bulb B is half filled. Whenever it consists of water, bulb B consists of bulb. Whenever the bulb B is half filled, we should suck that water up to upper mark. Observe here bulb B consists of two marks. We can observe here, it is upper mark.
This is the
upper mark and lower mark. Okay, upper mark and lower mark. No, no. Suck the water up to upper mark. Whenever it reaches to upper mark, we should leave our finger, then we should suck that water like this up to upper mark.
Okay, upper mark.
Whenever it reaches to upper mark, we can observe here, it consists of upper. Water is up to upper mark. Whenever it reaches to upper mark, we should remove our finger and allow that water to flow from upper mark to lower mark. Whenever we remove our finger, we should start the counting of time in seconds by using stopwatch.
Start 1, 2, 3.
Okay. Observe here. We started the stopwatch. We can observe here, time is measured by using stopwatch. So here our lower mark, water is reaches to lower mark. Okay, we should stop the stopwatch. Whenever water reaches to lower mark, we should stop the stopwatch and measure the time in seconds. Observe here, time is 47 seconds. Whenever the water reaches to lower mark, we should stop the stopwatch. Observe here, time is 2 minutes. 2 minutes is nothing but 120 seconds. Measure the time and repeat the same procedure with water and take the time. We should note the time. In second step, we need to take the given liquid, that is nothing but ethyl alcohol, in a Ostwald viscometer. Repeat the same procedure with ethyl alcohol. Observe here, we suck that ethyl alcohol up to upper mark. So leave your finger and start the stopwatch. Observe here, water comes from lower mark to upper mark. Alcohol comes from upper mark to lower mark. Observe here, it is ethyl alcohol which is fell down from upper mark to lower mark. Time is noted by using stopwatch, that is 3 minutes 55 seconds. Then come to calculation part. To calculate the viscosity of the given liquid, first we should note that value in a table. It consists of four columns: serial number, liquid, time of flow, average. Here first our liquid is water. Trial 1, 120 seconds. Trial 2, 125 seconds. Average time is 122 seconds. Next, ethanol. Trial 1, 235. Trial 2, 230. Average is 232. Consider it as T1, it as T2. Here, our formula, it is our formula to calculate the viscosity of the given liquid. That is, eta 1 by eta 2 equals to D1 T1 by D2 T2. Here, eta 1, D1, T1 values are water values. Eta 2, D2, T2 values are ethanol values. What is our aim? Our aim to calculate the eta 2 value. So, our modified formula to calculate eta 2 value is eta 2 equals to D2, T2 by D1, T1 into eta 1. Where D2 is constant value, T2 is, we will get the T2 value from exponent, T1 value from exponent, D1, D2, eta 1 values are fixed values. By substituting that fixed values and calculated values in this formula, we will get the eta 2 value. So eta 2 is nothing but surface tension of the given liquid, that is nothing but ethyl alcohol. Units for eta 2 value. Eta 2 is nothing but viscosity of the given liquid. Viscosity is nothing, given liquid is nothing but ethyl alcohol. So viscosity values of ethyl alcohol is 13.2 millipoise. Here millipoise are the values, units of viscosity.